Actually, my talk is called What I've Learned from My Parents. As far as humanity goes back, one thing is for sure, parents. And trust me, no matter how many generations you try to come back, your relatives would always have parents. So let's look at parenting in itself, how important it is, and how much they should be. Going back in time, parenting was different. Education was different. Instead of your old mumbling Mr. Gray in biology class, you would have your father teach your family business, that being only if you were a boy. If you were a girl, you would be taught things like cooking and weaving and cleaning the house. And however, that resulted in the children's options being narrowed down immensely. And you would not have this choice of selecting a course of study or a profession in place in which you want to work in. Now, however, we have schools, so we mostly learn away from home. That separation from home is smoothed out in a school society, yet school can never become your home. That being said, this system gives you a tremendous variety of choices. You can become whichever profession you want, be scientist, artist, even teacher. But if you look into our modern world, you would ask, if we really spend so much time in school, what effect do parents have on us now? They just seem like people who cook lasagna for us at home. And although lasagna can be important, parents play a huge role in kids' development. But when parents decide to be parents, or in some cases, become parents accidentally, I know who you are, who teaches parents how to be parents? Well, lucky for you, I am here today to teach you exactly that. In the present world, there are multiple ways of approaching parenting, and there always have been. Yet now, the separation of parenting techniques is most evident. Think of kids as a flame, and of parents as hands around the flame. So if the hands move too far away from the fire can expand and become uncontrollable, resulting in the kid giving little thought to rules or obligations. If, on the other side, the hands come too close, there will not be enough oxygen from the flame, and the flame inside the kid will be extinguished. In other words, you can either not look after your kid whatsoever, if this came out of my womb doesn't mean I need to teach it mindset, or not let your kid make a single step without you knowing about it. As you can hopefully tell, this can and does have negative impacts on your children. There are some advantages to these systems, yet the best approach to children is mix a little bit of everything. So let's start with no control whatsoever. This way, children learn independence in a very early stage of life. It is easier for them making independent decisions as well as living an independent life in the same house as you do, appearing only to be taken from school or to a dinner, spending most of the time outside or with their friends. However, that might sound good, but with the lack of guidance from his or her parents, the kid is more likely to make poor choices in life, have a less developed moral and ethical system, as well as try smoking and or drinking at a younger age. Children that are left for themselves can also develop and get used to things such as isolation and depression, which is in fact proved by a study conducted by Dr. Laura Markham, PhD, a clinical psychologist, who had stated that kids are more likely to push their limits, achieve lower standards, and have a risk of their safety if they're left for themselves. Now, let's take a look at the other side. A child that is very closely looked after. In this case, contrary to the previous one, it is rather a challenge for a child to develop personality, as children tend to overtake opinions and beliefs and behaviors from their parents, which can be both a bad and a good thing at the same time. But let's take first a close look at the negative side. In this case, it can prove harder for children to develop interests, especially in cases where parents want them doing specific things, like play sports, whereas in fact the person really likes music and singing. And quite often is the case also that they want to keep the children from making the same mistakes as they have in their childhood, and simply make a restriction on their behaviors. That can prove to be solving the issue of children committing the same mistakes as they have in their childhood, yet it doesn't teach them, it just eradicates the issue. It does sound like a good intention, but it might prove better to let children make mistakes so they can learn from them. But positively, Children do develop a stronger moral and ethical system, as well as the chances of oppression are also very low, which is in fact proved by another study conducted by Stacy Lynn, a University of London graduate, and she has stated that self-esteem, self-discipline, ambition, and emotional development are stunted without parental guidance and involvement, implying the opposite. Parents do affect us in a positive way. Now, my parents are amazing people, especially my mom. And to give you a little bit of context, I also have a younger brother who is younger than me by nearly 5 years. And why I am so proud of my mom is that when I was 8 years old, my parents divorced, and our mom took us, kept us, and saw that we became the best people we could. Personally, I'm getting there, but I just need a little bit more of time. But what my mom did is she melded both of the strategies above into a single balanced thing, maybe sometimes leaning towards the more controlling side, but nevertheless. And I'm very happy that I came out this way. And now that you know this, you must also understand that there's nothing a parent can do to have a perfect relationship with you. It is rather based on communication and trust from both sides. Today, I've provided you with two examples. Those are extremes, but it doesn't mean they don't exist today. The best approach to children is, in fact, to mix both of the strategies above into a single thing. Be close to your child, yet let them have the personal space and time to discover the world with you by their side. It is also important to develop a very strong, trust-based relationship with your child from a young age. In some sense, I am lucky. My parents aren't too screwed up as some, but others might not have the same luxury and have either too controlling or hands-off parents. In that case, it might be too late for you, but not too late for your children. Thank you.